Alberta has 1 year to overhaul its mental health law, after a court decision found that the existing rules allow doctors to confine and medicate a Calgary man against his will in violation of his charter rights. The Court of Queen's Bench Justice ruled six provisions under the Mental Health Act unconstitutional after reviewing a case centered on an Indigenous 49-year-old man given the initials JH to protect his privacy, who was detained for more than 9 months and medicated against his will at Foothills Hospital. In the ruling, the justice wrote that J.H. suffered multiple breaches of his fundamental rights to life, liberty, and security protected by Section 7 of the Charter, was arbitrarily detained in breach of Section 9, and was not given appropriate notice of the reason for his detention or his right to legal counsel in breach of Section 10 and B. Alberta Health Services is responsible for these breaches. J.H. was the victim of the 2014 hit and run and was hospitalized for injuries to his leg and back. While in hospital, he became homeless and had trouble accessing social assistance once he was discharged. He later returned to the hospital to receive surgery for complications arising from his injuries. But when it came time to discharge him, he was instead certified and held under the Mental Health Act. J.H. was then given psychiatric medications, which were not medically required, and that he was not told about his right to free legal advice within a reasonable time. The Mental Health Act's criteria for detaining people is too broad, and new safeguards need to be created to protect patients. In a mailed statement to CBC, both Alberta Justice and Oz said they are reviewing the decision, but there have been numerous cases like this over the years. J.H. was brought to Foothills by the Downtown Outreach Addictions Partnership Team for complications from his injuries, but after recovering for 20 days and showing signs of improvement, he wanted to be released. But on September 25, 2014, J.H. was held in hospital under the Mental Health Act, which allows doctors to detain patients they believe are suffering from a mental illness under certain circumstances. Despite J.H.'s lack of history with mental illness, doctors said he was disoriented, lacks insight into seriousness of his medical condition, states wants to leave hospital with an unsteady gait. According to the ruling, J.H. was treated with psychiatric medications, which were not medically required, without his consent. J.H.'s original admission certificate allowed him to be held at the hospital for 1 month, but he wasn't released until May 2015. Following an appeal in court, there were multiple issues with J.H.'s detainment, including vague and incomplete admission certificates, and the fact J.H. nor his family received written notice about why he was being held in hospital. "We need to bring the Mental Health Act in compliance with the Charter. We have a system that is operating without oversight, at least in Alberta. A checklist for physicians and nurses has been developed to outline the steps required when informing the patient about certification and ensuring the patient and their family members are aware of their rights. Brochures are also being handed out to patients so they are able to understand the role of a mental health patient advocate and access that support if they need it." The health organization said it's leaving any implications with changing the Mental Health Act up to the provincial government.